Assalamualaikum. Welcome to my channel Dev and Chat. Today I will show you how to build one cool button in HTML and CSS. And I hope you'll be also enjoying this project. Also, like you check my all the previous projects of HTML and CSS. So these projects which I am thinking of for you in HTML and CSS are some of the simple projects, but it is really helpful for you because you will be learning more things from there. Like previously we have built front page, background image, and now today I will show you how to build a cool button with a background color, and I will be showing you how to just put a hover effect on that, which should be really helpful for you, and it will be just really amazing to see that. So I hope you will be understanding that and you will be enjoying that. So if you are enjoying these videos also which I am bringing up, so please hit a like to this video, and if you are new on the channel also hit the subscribe button, because like these videos I will be bringing up in future in other programming languages also, and you can learn many other programming languages also. And just share this video so your family members and friends can also learn what is programming, how to do programming, what is HTML and CSS, and I will be also showing you other programming language. But for beginners, HTML and CSS is a good language, so because of that I am starting with that, and it clear all the doubts related to programming and related to programming languages also in their project. So because of that I just will be showing you the simple things, and then we will be just moving to websites also, how to build a website, how to build a responsive website in HTML, CSS, and many other things. So this we will be starting with our. So just like I'm telling you, we will be just building a cool button in HTML and CSS. So I will show you how to build that. But before that, I want to delete these things here because I don't need it. That simply I will be empty this recycle bin. Here I will be just doing one thing. Here you have to open your you have to just open your Sublime Text here. So simply write here Sublime Text to open. You can see I was just already working with this file, so it is opening. So I will be saving. I will be not saving, and I will be making two new files here in which we will be making our button. So here I will be now giving it to the name. First of all, I have to save, then write here button.html. Simply I will be writing. So like I'm telling you, take care about like when you're writing button. So .html should be after that, and then just save that on desktop. And this CSS file also I will be saving that on desktop. So simply come here and then write button.css, saving that on desktop here also. And you've done that, just move here, and then I will be writing some of the simple quotes of HTML. Just give the title of button. So here I will be writing, save this and open this button.html here. So you can see you have just opened our document, and now simply I will be half screening with this. So when you've done with that, here I will be doing one thing. Here I will be doing that, this like that. So you can see that now it is looking good. So when you've done that, here we are showing button written, because here the title is written button. Here I will be moving to body. Then simply I will be writing some of the things here like header, right here nav. Here I will be making a div tag, and I will be giving it a class. So you can just give any of the class name here. Simply I will be writing navbar. Just move down. Here I will be now writing a tag which should be like button. Right here, then in this button I will be writing read more. So here this button will be just really good if I will be just making that, save that, move here, save that also. So here you have to link this style sheet, so we can just style that, because button is simple and we have to style that, and all the work which we are doing in CSS file, so we have to link that, which is really important to do, because if you do not do that, your CSS code will be just really waste, because if you have not linked, so it will be not work. Refresh that, you can see we are getting our read more button simply here. So here this is our button, but it is not styled or it is not looking good here. Simply I will be moving here. I will be now giving it a margin of like 300 pixels. Save here and reload. You can see image is just the file has gone because we have given many of the margin, and it is coming here, but we don't want this like that. So simply I will be moving here, and this margin should be of padding. Save here and reload. You can see now when we have just given the padding, so it is just coming here. So like that, image is just this is really big. So here we will be giving that in class. So for doing that, simply I will be moving here, and then I will be raising that and writing dot nav bar here. Now I will be writing padding 20 pixel. Save that and reload. You can see now it is moving down. So simply I will be now, and I will be doing save that again and move down. So like that you can take your like this move. So you can just do like that. Simply I will be doing same of margin also, and then do like that. So you can see we are just getting our this down. So here will be changing that to 300 and is in this margin. Save and reload. So you can see it is just moving here. So now here we are just getting this, and here I will be now doing one thing, like here I will be doing like that and reload this. So here we are just not getting this format. So here I will be now writing margin, which should be 500 pixels. Save and reload. So you can see that our this is moving. So here when you've done that, simply I will be doing that here like that, and 300, save here and reload, and you can see it is coming in center. So we are just getting our button in center, you can see, but it is not quite in center, but we are just getting. Simply I will be doing one thing here. Now I will be giving a font family here, so our read mode should be looking good. So simply I will be giving that to Poppins comma sans edit. So here I will be showing you where it is. You can see here it is. Now I will be just saving that and reloading that. You can see now it is changed into Poppins. Here I will be taking this to big. So simply I will be moving. Then here I will be writing like font size, which should be like 20 pixel. Save here and reload. You can see this font size is just really short. So here I will be now doing one thing here, like moving forward down. So here when you've done with that, simply do that 60 and save and reload. So you can see nothing is happening here. So here simply I will be coming, then I will be giving it to button. Here I will be now simply writing that thing which I have written there. So here I will be writing font size 20 pixel, save here and reload. You can see now our button is moving big. So like that I will be taking it more bigger, so it should be just looking good here. So simply 50 and reload. You can see now this is big, but we don't want like it should be more bigger. So here I will be now doing like this, reload, but still it is big. So here I will be doing 30, reload, and we want to check that it's looking good, but it is still moving in other line. So here I will be doing one thing. Simply I will be coming here and changing that to 25. Save here, reload. Still it is not coming good. 22, reload that. You can see now it is good. So here we are just getting that, and now I want that we should be getting a good background here. So before the background, I want to style this button. So simply I will be giving this the width of 200 pixel. Save here and reload. So you can see we are just getting the width of this button. Now here I will be writing the padding 13 pixel. Save and reload. You can see we are getting the padding also from here. And here I will be now changing this padding to bigger, and this width to 400. Save here, reload, and you can see that how we are just getting this, but we don't want it should be look like that. Simply I will be doing that to 350. Save here, reload. Still it is looking like that. So simply I will be doing 250. Save and reload. So now it is looking good. So like that we are getting, and we want some of the, like you can say here a border radius. So for taking a border radius, you have to do one thing. Simply move here, then you have to just write border radius, and here I will be giving that 40 pixels. Save here, reload. You can see border radius we are just getting, but still the button is not looking so much good. So simply I will be moving here, and then I will be just giving the border here of 1 pixel solid, and here I will be just giving the color which I will be giving to my button. So simply I will be moving here and writing color picker, and from here I will be picking really good colors, because there are many good colors which you can see. So dark color I want like this. Just I will be copying that and pasting here, and then I will be writing background. Here also I will be pasting that color code. Save here, reload here. You can see we are just getting this, and it is looking good. So when you've done that, here I want my read mode should be white color, so it will be looking good. So you can see we are just getting, and I want like this should having a word spacing. So here I will be writing word spacing. Save, reload. You can see we are just getting one word spacing here, and it is really unique, I was just saying. So here I will be now changing that to 10, and here I will be writing letter spacing 3 pixels. Save here, reload here. You can see we are just getting our word spacing and our letter spacing. So you can see how outlooking is that, and I will be just giving the background of, you can say, black. So simply I will be moving, writing background of black. Save and reload. You can see now how good looking is our button. It is just looking good here. And now simply I will be giving a hover effect to it. So here I will be now moving, and here I will be writing button, semicolon, hover. Here I will be writing color, and just color I want that, just it should be same. Color should be white and the background should be black, like the background which we have done in our this page. And here I want one thing, like my border should be 2px solid white, and here also I will be writing 2px. Save here, reload that, and if I hover, you can see we are just getting a beautiful hover effect on our button. And here I will be just doing one thing, I will be giving a transition so it can just looking more good. Just ease, save that, and move here again. And if I just scroll up and give a hover effect, you can see how cool it is looking. So you can see our button is just looking really good, and we are just getting a hover effect in that, which is just looking really more beautiful. You can see. So like that you can work with it, and like that you can just make own button. So here we have just I just show you how to build a button in HTML and CSS with background color. So like that you can build. So I hope you understand this video and enjoy this video, because we have put many of the things and many of the features in that which you learned, and I hope you enjoy that. So if you enjoy, so please hit a like to this video, and if you're new on the channel, also hit the subscribe button and share this video with your friends and family members, so they can also learn what is button, how to make that, and how to make with HTML and CSS, what is HTML and CSS, because these things are really important for you and for friends and your family members, so they can learn and get a job in future by learning these things and by showing their skills, because these coming up, all the coming up things are on computer like laptop. So because of that we are using programming languages also, and these programming languages are really important. Like if you want to make any website of your own, like portfolio or anything like that, you can just use HTML and CSS to make, or any other language like Python, Django, or any other one you can just use to make these website. But we are, like I'm telling you, in the starting also we are starting with basic. So because of that I'm just showing you some of the basic things of HTML and CSS. So I hope you understand that, and just I will be meeting you next process for today. Goodbye.